Hey guys, Kevin the Comic Doctor coming to another episode of What's in the Press. That's right, we haven't had a What's in the Press for a really, really long time, and I thought today I'd go on here and give you an episode because, well, let's face it, we haven't had one in a long time, and I'm still working on comics. I'm working on comics a hell of a lot, and I want to show you guys what's been going on around here because, you know what, I have had a ton of high-end books dropped off over the last several weeks. I've had rare books, big books, and I don't always share them here on the show. But I want to come on here and show you that I'm still chipping away at them. And this is one of the reasons why I'm actually a little bit behind on the regular books because these keep coming in. I can't believe how many rare, awesome books are coming in. You got a little bit of a glimpse of one on the thumbnail of this video, but I will, I'll share a whole bunch with you, actually. Hey, guys, if you're new here, I'm Kevin the Comic Doctor. I'm a comic book presser and CGC-authorized dealer located up in Oshawa, Ontario, Canada. And just because I'm in Canada doesn't mean you have to go anywhere because I also service customers, lots of customers down in the United States. So sit back, relax. And hit that subscribe button and that like button. And I'm going to start right off the bat with one of my American clients. Actually, this book comes to me from Vito out of California. And this is what we got. We got a copy of Daredevil number two. But not only does Vito send me a copy of Daredevil number two, he also sends me a copy of Daredevil. You can't have number two, right, without number one. And it's a nice copy as well. And that's all that Vito sent me. But you know what? Two massive books. And usually I would have these books done like that. But because I'm getting inundated with... it's a bad problem to have, I guess. Right, guys? Even the higher-end books aren't getting done as quickly as I would like. Next, we got an order from Kevin out of Northern Ontario. And Kevin's been waiting very patiently as well. He sends me four books. We'll start off with a nice copy, actually, of Marvel Superheroes featuring Captain Marvel number 12. But Vito also sends me a copy of Hulk 180, Hulk 182. And was that nice of me to skip over the big kahuna? Was that nice of me to skip over? Because you know what I have here, right, guys? You, of course, I've got a copy of Hulk 181 right there. And again, some nice copies of these first appearances of Wolverine, the first three appearances of Wolverine and Captain Marvel. Kevin, again, thank you for your patience. Your books are finally going to get done. And this is a massive order that came in from Halifax, from Mike out in Halifax. And you saw some of the, you saw the thumbnail, a lot of old Bat books, guys, a lot of everything, which is crazy. Let me actually get organized here. I'm looking at the chat room. I'm probably not going to see a lot of people here today because this is an impromptu What's in the Press. So I don't think we're going to see a lot of people here on the show today, but that's okay. We'll keep it intimate and other guys can watch it on the fly later on. Get kind of organized. All right. So first off, Mike. Wow. Look at this. Gonna move those over. Mike sends us a copy of really nice copies. Amazing Spider-Man number 9. That's a clean copy. First appearance of Electro. Not one of these books is a small book in this order. This order is, when I saw the submission form, I'm like, wow, what a collection. And they're not in any particular order. We're going to jump around here a little bit. Next, we've got a nice copy of Batman number 31. If you like your Golden Age books, you've come to the right place this week, guys. All right, next, another one. You know what? That's okay. One copy. What the heck? Let's have two copies. Batman 31. Again, first appearance of Sandman. Amazing Spider-Man number 4. Wow, you guys have come to the right place. And you know what? If today's episode of Moon Knight was any indication of how good that show is going to be and how popular this book is going to continue to be, wow, that I enjoyed that episode, guys. We'll talk about that when we go to the chat. I think someone asked, I think Nick asked about it. We'll talk a little bit about it today. First appearance of Ghost Rider, anybody? Marvel Spotlight number 5. Amazing Spider-Man number 8. Here it is. Batman number 11. Very famous Joker cover, little cards in the background. It's an awesome cover. Then we got a Batman number 49. Again, no particular order, guys. Just a lot of beautiful Bat books here. Then we got a World War II Batman number 18 right there. With Hirohito and Mussolini and Adolf Hitler on the front cover. It's one of the, let me see if I can get that in focus there. There you go. Very famous cover. Okay, how about a first appearance of the Sinister Six in a number one, Amazing Spider-Man. Oops, come on, getting to focus there. Amazing Spider-Man Annual. Why is it not focusing today? There we go. There we go. Annual number one, first Sinister Six, sort of in focus. Another popular Bat book, issue number 40, another Joker cover. Very popular book. Yeah, guys, you don't see a What's in the Press like this too often. There's not any ASM 361s today, that's for sure. Target Comics, number 10, volume 1, number 10. We already saw one Werewolf by Night. How about another Werewolf by Night first appearance? And actually, not a bad looking book. Not bad at all. Batman number 42. Nice crisp copy of Amazing Spider-Man 50 with the first appearance of the Kingpin. Another ASM book that's after No Way Home came out, just spiked. Amazing Spider-Man 16 with the first, is it the first encounter between Daredevil and Spider-Man? I think it is. Then we got a Batman number 37. I think I might have a copy of this book actually myself. I believe I do. Another Bat book, Batman number 48. Amazing Spider-Man 121 with the death of Gwen Stacy. And who's that guy that killed Gwen Stacy? Well, it's none other than the Green Goblin right here. Amazing Spider-Man 14. Then we got a Batman number 39, another famous cover, the ice skating cover. That's pretty cool. House of Secrets number 92, first appearance of Swamp Thing. We have another famous, or no, I wouldn't say famous, but popular Joker cover in Batman number 44. Those Joker covers are hot. And last but not least in this batch of books, guys, Amazing Spider-Man number 15 with the first appearance of Kraven the Hunter. So a lot of Bat books, a lot of Spidey books, nothing wrong with that. So again, guys, Comic Doctor is hard at work here. It's hard at work. I'll be honest, this week, all, you know, I haven't done much pressing on Monday. Monday I did invoicing. Yesterday I did some CGC ordering, and today I prepped a bunch of packages. It takes me forever to pack things up and ship things out. I had a couple of guys waiting for their books, Derek out of Montreal and Paul up in Northern Ontario, waiting for their books. They've been here for a couple. I just did not have a chance to get the books all ready and prepped and sent out. But now they are. They're going out tomorrow, so very happy. Let's go over to the chat room and see what's here. I increased the size of the window in the chat. Hopefully everyone can see it a little bit better. Oh, I can see it better. There we go. Nick Parker says, good evening, Doc. Hope you have been well. I have been, Nick. Just busy, busy, busy. How did you like the first episode of Moon Knight? I'm still processing it myself. You know what? I liked it. I thought it was the best first episode of any of the series, the TV series we've seen so far. I also thought it was the most cinematic. And, you know, I've been hearing people complaining about the CGI, and I thought it looked just fine. I really actually liked the series. I liked they're taking their time. I hope we're not going to run out of time. I find that when these episodes come towards the end, we've run out of time. There's not, you know, it's like they could have used another episode or two. And I hope that will not be the case with this one too. A lot of unpacking to do, letting us, because most people don't know anything about Moon Knight. So this is a new character. We're getting to know him. And I like that we spent time with Steven. That was great. And now Mark's coming around. That's pretty cool too. So I guess Mark understands that he's also Moon Knight. That's all going to come about, but I did like it. I actually did. And you know what, guys, if you're just getting here now, and if you're thinking about subscribing to the channel, I think you really should, because yeah, Moon Knight did drop today, and I'm not sure when I'm going to do it, but over the next, oh, that's a blank one there. What's that? That's not a blank one. It's just backwards. There we go. One, two, three, what's going on here? What is that? Oh, it is a blank. Nothing in there. Anyways, I'll be giving out these Moon Knight books, these Bill Sienkiewicz covers over the next week or so. I'm not sure. When I have time, I'll get on here. We'll do maybe after the second episode or the third episode, we'll come on here. We'll have a Moon Knight discussion, and I'll give out these awesome Moon Knight books. They are hot right now. And maybe I'll give them a quick press for whoever wins them too, because they look like they sure could use it. Anyways, again, giving out these Moon Knight books soon. Oh, how you doing? Luke's here. I haven't seen you in a while, Luke. How you doing? And James is here from New Mexico. How you doing? Nick Parker says, holy goaty Batman. I know. Like I said, when I received that order, I was going, wow, I can't wait to get these books and get my hands on them. And as I'm looking at these books, I'm thinking, oh man, they're going to turn out great, because there's a few in there that can surely use the touch. And I'm going to certainly do that and make them as beautiful as I possibly can. And they'll be going all off to CGC as well. Hey, Wayne, how's it going? Nick also says, some nice books so far. Those Daredevils look great. Yeah, the Daredevils are pretty nice too. And like I said, I usually, you know, when I get one or two higher end books, I try to get them done fast, and I just can't get them done anymore. I just can't get on top of it, guys. I don't know what I'm going to do. It's crazy. It's crazy frustrating, actually, but... anyhow, Luke says, very nice Golden Age stuff. That's a nice Catwoman cover. Yeah, they're all beautiful books, man. They're all beautiful books. Nick says, and Steven wakes up next week and it is the finale. Yeah, you never know. You didn't like the jumping around there? They're having fun with us a little bit. They're letting us understand there's lost time. Something's going on. Well, I'm sure we'll figure it out as the weeks go by. Yeah, thanks for the 1,400 sub. Congratulations, Luke. Actually, it's 1,401, I think, as of today, I think. So in 99 more subs, I'll be giving out a $250 Comic Doctor gift certificate as well. And so be sure to subscribe, like, and hit that notification bell too, so you know when I come on here. Like I said, not a lot of chat going on. I'm not sure even how many guys are on the site right now. There's only about 10 people on here right now. That's not too bad. And almost 7 likes. I just want to, again, guys, I just want to come on here and say hello and give you an update as what's going on. I'm probably not going to do another What's in the Press for quite a while, but there will be another unboxing at some point this week. I do have a box that I have to share with everybody, and I haven't had a chance to do that. I was going to do that tonight. I'll do that probably on maybe Friday, or, you know. Oh, there's more questions coming. I'll transition back. Wayne says, you can't get to the big books because of those big orders. Big orders. That was a 25 book order too. All those big books came from one client. So what do I do? Do I do them all at once? Probably not. I'll probably take me a couple of weeks to get those done. I'll probably do 12 this week, 12 next week. And I have some other big money books too. Again, guys, I have clients who don't want their books shared on What's in the Press, you know, so I don't always show you everything. There's been a couple of big books that have come through here, recently, you know, and they just don't want them shown. That's fine. You know, if you don't want them on there, that's okay. I don't have to show them. Hey, Davey, how's it going? My house for sale is under contract and giving to, okay, let's try that again. My house, I guess, is for sale, under contract, and going to walk away with around 150K. What's one book I should buy under 20,000? So, David, you were going to put some money aside for a comic? Is that what your intention is? For under $20,000? Is that what you're... yeah? If you can still find one, and I think you can, you could probably buy a 3 or a 4... I think I'd buy an Amazing Spider-Man #1. I think so. I don't think you're going to find an AF-15. I saw 0.5 AF-15s were selling. I know an AF-15 0.5 sold at the recent Comic-Con for, I think, 22 or 23,000. So that's not happening. But I have a feeling that I think the prices are going to start coming down a little bit. I think the prices are going to start coming down a little bit. But yeah, I think a Spider-Man book is a good investment. You can never go wrong with that. Maybe an X-Men number one, if you go find an X-Men number one, but I still think ASM number one's probably, well, you know, I think X-Men number one, if you want one that's going to pop in value, I think X-Men number one is probably a better bet because they still haven't made any announcements yet. They haven't said anything about X. Well, they kind of alluded to it with Doctor Strange, but as soon as the X-Men are officially in the MCU, that book I think is going to pop even more. So perhaps X-Men number one or an FF number one, lower grade, you know, but I think a 2.0 FF number one's hitting is getting close to 20 grand now. I think maybe it is already there. Gilbert, how's it going, Gilbert? Have you considered not submitting books to CGC and just focus on pressing to catch up, Gilbert? I wish. That's what I always said I was going to do that. But everybody wants CGC. Everybody. I tried to get away from CGC on so many occasions. Luke is still here. He can attest to that. Luke's been around and knew that I complained about it. I said, I'm not doing it anymore. But every single person who comes to me wants CGC. Look, as long as everybody's aware of it and patient with the with how long it's going to take to get the books back, CGC is not a lot of work, really. What's a lot of work with? You see, if your order, for example, is finished and I put your order into CGC's site immediately, it's not so bad. The problem is if I don't do that and I have 10 orders I haven't put in yet, that's a bad thing. So it's on me to be. Disciplined to say, okay, this order, Gilbert's order is now finished. He wants it to go to CGC. I have to do the paperwork for it. Once the paperwork's done, I pack it and get it ready and just put your stuff aside until I get a few more parcel or a few more packs and I send them all. It's not really that time consuming. What sucks about CGC is the boxes, man. I got so many boxes and I got nowhere to put them. That's my problem. And I'm kind of not sure what I'm going to do, to be honest. I got more and more boxes coming in and lots of these books. And what sucks is because economy, or if you give me an order with economy books and modern books, the moderns are going to come first. But if you're from out of town, you know, like today, I think it was Derek's books. He had, I think, six moderns and the rest were, I think, I want to say they were either economy or standards. So half the order came first. And I was waiting for months for the other order. And that's what sucks, right? I'm waiting for orders to finish. Sometimes I'll have eight books. I'm waiting for just one more book. And it might take, look at that magazine I was waiting for almost a year. The rest of the guy's books have been here for 6 months. That's what kind of sucks. So I have all these books on hand, which I don't want. I want to get them out of here. But you know what? You're right. It's not a bad idea. Not a bad idea, Gilbert, but I think they would run me out of town if I did that. Hi, Celeste, if you're there, by the way. Nick Parker, how many ASMs can he buy? Number ones with 20,000? It depends on the grade. I think a 3 or a 3.5 is going for around 12 now. You know? I think a 2.5 X-Men number one is around. Again, guys, I see the prices on like different pages. So, but I think an X-Men number one and a 2.5 is around 15, 16, I think. You know? Prince Zodiac, hey, Neil, how's it going? What's happened? I couldn't find the stream because I didn't recognize the gentleman. I know. No one. I'm surprised no one mentioned it. I had enough. I couldn't do it anymore. It was driving me. I had it since the fall. I was growing it out since September, October. And it never really bothers me, but the last week or so, it was starting to bug me. And I said, okay, it's coming off now. Let my beautiful skin breathe now. And I'll grow it back. I'll grow it back probably in the fall. I'll grow it back again. I like having a beard, but this time of year, it's time to get rid of it and, you know, let her go. You can buy the Action Comics one. That's right, Luke. You could. There's a piece of Action Comics number one, just a piece you could buy for $7,000 US. Oh, yeah, Nick Park. I meant ASM-361s. Yeah, you can buy tons of those. Luke says, Dr. Doom is a good... Yeah, Dr. Doom, the first appearance of Dr. Doom in Fantastic Four, number 5 is a good one, but this very expensive. Very, very expensive book. It may have already gotten to that point where it's like... It's gone higher and bigger than I think FF number 1. And how fast it's going up, it's crazy. Davey Clare says, saw FF Annual 6 in a 9.8 on eBay for $57,000. Holy shit. What's Annual 6? Which one's that? Is that the one with... Remind me. You're the only really... And Luke says, you're the only... Sorry. You're the only one really in this area for CGC stuff that doesn't require a 25 sub. People are making you do 25 book submissions? That's crazy. I wouldn't do that. I have guys give me one book, which even one book, even just for pressing, they give me one book. It's really not worth it. Like I had one guy send me one book from Toronto. It cost him probably $10 to ship it to me, $25 for the press, and another $15 to ship it back. And he didn't want to have it graded. And I'm like, that to me, that's kind of just a waste of money. But that's crazy. 25, so that's a lot. It's a lot of money. You're expecting people to shell out a lot of cash for 25 books. Hey, Tom, how's it going? Nick Parker, what about limiting how many books you send to CGC? I don't know. I've done limit. What I've done now, guys, I've frozen everything. I'm not taking any. People can put out submission forms now. And you know, some of those people are not going to come through with those submission forms. And I understand that, and I don't care. That's fine. But fill out a submission form now, and by doing so, you'll get yourself ahead of yourself in the queue. But right now, I'm not actively taking in any books, and that way, I can just kind of hammer. Me and Charlo can hammer through what we've got here, and I might not take any for quite a while. I might not take any for a couple of months. That's going to be at least that, I think, for me to catch up. I did a whole bunch of unboxings today, like not CGC unboxings, all the leftover FedEx boxes and UPS boxes that I had. I purged it last night. That's something else I did last night, and. A lot of books came in again. A lot of books. So I'm at again critical mass. I got enough work here. I got enough work to last me to summertime. Easily to the summer if I wanted to. Let's see who else. Did I miss any? Nick Parker. What about? Okay, thanks. A good idea though. Hey, hard name to say, man. I always have a hard time saying that one. Where'd he go? NDFND. What's up, Doc? Not much. How are you doing, buddy? Looking good, brother. Looking good. Thanks, Prince Zodiac. Hey, Dennis is in the house. A long time no see, Dennis. I'm keeping my Corona beard. Well, you can do that. I'll keep a little goat. That's what I'm going to do. I like my goat. That's it. And when I drop another 15, 20 pounds, I lose the goat, too. Then I can show my chiseled jawline. Right now, I don't have one. Franklin Richards, I think, or FF. Oh, number 6. Oh, that's cool. Oh, you know, I can show you guys, actually. I'll show you something in a second. You guys want to see a bit of the collection I picked up the other day? Dating. So don't make fun of her name. Okay, Dennis, I won't. Michael, how you doing, buddy? Did Kevin Kleen impress his beard? Yeah, it's gone. RP's in the house. Long time, RP. Hey, Kevin, sorry I missed this in earlier video, but what month's books are you on now? Right now, I'm working on a span anywhere from September's pretty much almost done, but September, some's leftovers in September, and I'm working to books into late November right now. If there's smaller orders, like orders of two or three, we're trying to get those done. So some of those are even kind of recent, but I'm getting those done. The bigger orders are taking a little bit longer, but they're going to get done. They're going to get done. And I still say, don't worry. It's going to be 6 to 9 months to get them back. In fact, Derek's books, I'm sending them back to Montreal tomorrow. He mailed those books to me in April of last year, I believe. And he's getting them back in March. Or no, March of last year. So exactly 1 year. But honestly, they've been back sooner than that. I just been very tardy getting them back to him, like mailing them back to him. But they've been in-house for probably about a month, month and a half. Brouhaha. Hey, man, how you doing? Davey Clare, first analyst, and Franklin. That's how much that book is in a 9.8. Wow. Prince Zodiac. Yeah, I have two invoices that were able to be sent, but I'm still waiting to send them so I don't swamp you. I've got your... I looked through your books today, actually, Neil. Very nice. Very nice books. Chiseled jaw, baby. Chiseled jaw. RP says, I have you some books back in the end of November, early December. If I wanted to add, swap a book from the three I gave you already, can I do that or wait in queue again? You can do it, RP, but give me a call on the phone to discuss it. I have to dig them out and find your invoice, and it's a bit of work, but, you know, we can do it if we have to, yeah. Luke, lots of that McFarlane Wolverine cover from unboxings nowadays. Yes. Yeah, a lot of that. Here, hold on. I'm going to show you guys a little something. Enjoy that. You might like this. Hold on. All right. So on Sunday, I drove out about an hour east of here. A guy was selling some books. He had a New Mutants 98 that I wanted. And, you know, we agreed on a price, and, you know, buying a book on a picture, not a very high res picture, is nothing I would recommend to anybody. And sure enough, when I got there, the book was not minty at all. I mean, it was probably, when I'm done with it, it'll probably be like, like a 9. I'm hoping we get a 9.4, maybe a 9.6. I doubt it, but I'm hoping for a 9.4. But he had a bunch of other books. So check these out. They're all moderns, by the way. So I picked these up. I think you'll like them. I'll get rid of the chat room for a second. Sit back, relax, and see what I picked up. Will I ever have a chance to work on any of these books? Yeah, probably not. That collection I bought a few months back, portion of it's right there. I haven't even friggin' looked at the damn thing. I pressed maybe six of them. And I'm going to do the New Mutants 98 quickly, but that's it. The rest are going to be sitting here for a while. Anyways, I'll go to the big screen so you guys can check these out. Okay, the first one's a Wolverine number 90. I know nothing about this book. All I know is I press it. People give it to me a lot, so I would imagine it's kind of important. Here's another Wolverine here. 88, is it? I think it's a Deadpool Wolverine cover. I think that's why it's so popular. I'm not sure if this is popular or not, but number 75 or 85. X-Force number 1, not a big deal really. X-Force number 4. Couple of X-Force 3s with Juggernaut. You mentioned Franklin Richard. So I got this in it. This looks really nice, actually. This one here looks really nice. So I don't have a copy of this for my own collection. I was happy to grab that. A lot of Deadpool. Whoops. You know, some Deadpool X-Forces, you know, not bad. And then a couple of, you know, these are, this I've been seeing a lot. This book's really getting hot like crazy. I got two or three copies of that now. This one here has been coming into the office a little bit more. Here's a Silver Surfer 50. Wolverine 50. Some of those Wolverine books are starting to go up. It's craziness. You know, number 2 of X-Force, so the Deadpool cover. This is not in great shape, but first Psylocke. Probably like a 6 or 7, not very good. First Legion. The Wolverine number 1, not in bad shape. So, you know, probably like $100, $150 book right there. And of course, this is the New Mutants 98 I picked up. And it does need some work. There we go. It's not bad. It's not terrible. But, you know, it's got a little color break down here. It's not going to be a 9.8. There's no chance of it. But you know, like I said, it could come back a 9.4. I think a 9.4 is a safe bet on that one. So that's not too bad. The number 75. And these Warlock books are starting to get popular, right? So Warlock number 1. And then these two books, like, again, I got a few of these now. I love these. These Jim Lee. Are they both Jim Lee or one just Jim Lee? That's Jim Lee, and this is, no, it's not Jim Lee. Oh, yeah, Jim Lee after John Byrne, I think. And those are popular because that's the art that was used on the Wolverine video games, right? So that's what I picked up. I picked up that on Sunday. I never like to say how much I paid, but I can tell you I paid more than 500, but not a lot more than 500. Okay? Canadian. So I think I did okay. If that Wolverine comes back and that Franklin Richards one comes back a decent grade, then you know, I've done all right. A lot of these books are, I got to inspect these books. If they're, you know, if they're not going to be 9898, in my opinion, I'll probably put them in the shop. I'll put them in the shop. They're all near mint books, but they might not all come back super high grade. All right, let's go back to the chat, and then I'm going to get out of here and go to bed because I'm tired. Let's see here. Reed Richards' beard didn't catch on. That's right. He did have a beard for a while. Hey, Brouhaha, David Clare. First, okay, we said that already. Prince Zodiac. Yeah, I have two invoices. We did that already. What's going on here? What's going on here? Oh, there. Okay, sorry. Hey, James, how's it going? The Real Hyperion's in the house. NDFND says, are the foil covers a hassle to press? No, it depends. No, they're not. What's usually a hassle is the fact that most of the time the foil covers are embedded in like a thicker cardstock cover. And there's only so much you can do with those cardstock covers if they're damaged, right? If they're dented or whatever. Yeah, you just don't expect miracles with those types of books, right? Now, like I said, if your whole front cover or your whole cover, the wrap is foil, the whole thing is foil, like foil front and back, like almost like a cellophane, you can't press that. I wouldn't recommend pressing that. You're going to shrink it. When you add a heat to that, the foil shrinks. But a foil or a hologram in the middle of a card, like ASM 365, not a problem. Not a problem. Luke says, what about a Comic Doctor special episode of What's in the Press? All the stuff you need to get pressed. Yeah, that would take several days. I couldn't even, oh my Lord. That would take several days. So 20 years after Singer's X-Men, Wolverine is selling. Yeah, I know, eh? I think it's been selling before that, Dennis, but it's just starting to get even hotter. Yeah, Jim Lee covers are great. No, he had no DC in this collection. It was all X-Men stuff. Nick Parker, did you ever want to see some great Fantastic Four covers? Look for Marvel Knights 4. The series is from early 2000s, and majority of the covers are beautiful. Look those up. I'll have to look those up. Dennis says, okay, we're just continuing on that. Dan's Basement. Hey, Doc, loving the show. Thanks, Dan. Thanks for being here. Appreciate it. Nick says, NFDN talks to Nick. That's cool. Nick says, the series is called Marvel Knights 4. Okay, yeah, we talked about that. Dennis Mason says, Reynolds Wolverine. Yeah, it's going to be hot. All right, guys, that's awesome. Well, listen, I hope you like that little collection I picked up. And you know what? We've been going for about 33 minutes. I'm tired. It's around almost 11 o'clock, and I've been up since around 8, and I'm zonked. Time for bed. But again, remember, guys, Moon Knight series dropped today. If you haven't watched it already, get on to Disney Plus and check it. It's really quite good. In my opinion, it's the best first episode of any of the Disney Plus Marvel shows as of yet. I really did enjoy it. It was top notch, in my opinion. I hope it can stick the landing, unlike Boba Fett or any of the other, you know, some of the other ones that we saw, like Hawkeye, which it was just, they were just okay. Again, remember, guys, giving these Moon Knight books out, probably do a Moon Knight. I'm not sure if I'll do a Moon Knight like halfway through the series, like episode 3. I'll stop. I'll give it a couple of books, and then we'll wait to the very end. I'll give it a couple more. I don't know, something like that. But in order to win, you must be a member of the channel. So please hit subscribe. Hit the subscribe button. Hit the like button. And again, hit those notification buttons so you'll know when I come on live again. Like tonight, I sometimes do impromptu videos. I apologize for those of you that were unable to be here live and join in the chat. But that being said, those that were here, we had a fun time, and I appreciate you for being here and asking all those questions. Have a fantastic rest of your evening, and the weekend's almost here, and we'll see you soon for another unboxing. Until next time, my friends, take care. Have a good night. Bye for now.